Deputy Jonathan O'Brien for Sinn Féin, please.
Thank you, Lass Concora. Tánaiste, on Monday I attended the local JPC meeting in Cork City in City Hall, where the growing issue of drug addiction and drug-related crime was discussed with the Chief Superintendent. And we heard from the Chief Superintendent that there's been a recent spike in muggings and robberies, which he has put down to, in part, being the growing issue of drug abuse and drug addiction within Cork City. We now heard that there are 500 heroin addicts in Cork, whereas 10 short years ago we had 20. It is estimated that there are 12 deaths every week from drug-related causes, with almost 5,500 deaths from drug overdoses and drug-related causes since records began in 2004. 8 in 10 of those deaths are young men, with over half having mental health issues. Tánaiste, communities and families are being torn apart by drug addiction. And your government's response since coming into office has been less than adequate. You have cut funding to Drug Task Force by 37% since coming into office. You have community support groups who are struggling to deal with the issue, to deal with a growing demand being placed on them, with reduced resources. And since 2011, figures obtained yesterday state that 108 Gardaí have been pulled from drug squads nationally. We have a national drug strategy with 63 actions, and 19 government agencies and departments having a direct role and responsibility in implementing that strategy. Yet for the first time in 21 years, we have a government without a minister or junior minister with specific responsibility for drugs. Tánaiste, it's time that this government took the issue seriously, took the responsibility in dealing with this issue, and appoint a specific minister, junior minister, with sole responsibility for drugs.
Thank you, Deputy Tánaiste.
Thank you. The National Drug Strategy 2009 to 2016, it's a cross-cutting area of public policy and public service delivery. And significant progress is being made in the implementation of the strategy across the key areas of policy: supply reduction, prevention, treatment, rehabilitation and research. And I should mention that in relation to my own department, we have ring-fenced, as I think the Deputy is aware, 1,000 places in community employment to ensure that people who are in rehabilitation from having had difficulties with addiction, that in fact they have opportunities around education, training and ultimately getting involved in work. And I have to say, there's been no reduction in resources from my own department in that respect. We have kept the ring fence numbers, and we have an opportunity, in fact, for more people, if they so desire, to take up those opportunities. And there has been no cut in relation to the resources in 2015. And I know, for instance, in relation to Minister Varadkar, that Minister Varadkar declared, as the Minister for Health, a very strong interest to, in terms of the health side of the policy implementation, to be directly involved in relation to the development and the implementation of the drug strategy. The Garda Síochána have targeted intelligence-led operations, which have led to, we know, significant seizures of illicit drugs. Drugs with a value of 41 million were seized in the first half, for instance, of 2014, which is much, much higher than the same period in 2013. And the Department of Children and Youth Affairs has been spending something like 51 million on an annual basis in relation to schemes involving young people, which would help in terms of deterring and avoiding becoming involved in drugs and in substance use. The improvements in availability and access to treatment at the end of September 2014. 97% of clients over the 18 years accessed treatment within one calendar month of assessment. But I do agree with you. It's a terrible difficulty. It's a scourge for the individuals and for their families who are affected. And I've had an opportunity, as I say, particularly in terms of the work of my own department, to visit a lot of community employment schemes around the country, right around the country, and in fact to expand, for instance, the provision of services in Waterford and Wexford to meet people. And you know what people tell me constantly is that they may have started in terms of substance abuse, whether that's drinking alcohol or in a lot of cases cannabis, as young as 13, and then found themselves unable to cope with the difficulties around addiction.
Thank you, Deb.
But if we can help them in terms of getting clean and then of finding a different pathway in terms of rehabilitation, people, and I know many people who have recovered and who have put their difficulties with addiction long behind them, and many of them are now counsellors to other people currently experiencing the difficulties.
Thank you, Janice.
The government has committed very significant investment to this through the strategy.
Margaret, Deputy Jonathan O'Brien, supplementary question.
I think by your own response, Minister, it's clear, and I'm sure you will agree, that this is a very complex issue, and it's not just around drug addiction. There are many other issues related to that, including mental health. And we've discussed some of those issues previously in this chamber. And it's for that very reason, Minister, when you consider we have a national drug strategy with 63 action points that covers 19 government agencies and departments, that is the reason why it's very important that we have somebody with sole responsibility for overseeing this issue. And that's why, Minister, I'm asking, will the government commit to appointing a junior minister with specific responsibility for this area? It's all well and good in saying that the minister sitting next year has decided to take a very direct role in it himself. I'm sure that minister is extremely busy in his own capacity as Minister for Health, but many other pressures and issues facing him. And therefore, if the government is serious, and I hope you are serious, Tánaiste, about dealing with this issue, then why is it that for the first time in 21 years we have a government with no junior minister with specific responsibility for drugs? And again, I will ask, will you please commit to appointing one?
Thank you. Tánaiste.
Well, I agree with you. It's an extremely complex issue, you know, which affects, because, as I say, through going around to communities, particularly visiting community employment schemes, which are focused on rehabilitation, education and training and employment possibilities for people who have been involved in substance abuse. I mean, I'm just always shocked at the sheer calibre of the people whom this affects. And to be honest, they come from all walks of life, some of the brightest people and the most creative people you'd ever meet, and they end up with this problem. And it's horrible for them and it's horrible for their families. Now, you talk about Minister of State, for instance. Well, in my own case, the Minister of State in my own department, Kevin Humphreys, actually, as much as I do, spends a huge amount of time visiting the different groups and organisations. So if you're saying that you want to see more ministerial attention directed to all areas of drugs, I know from Minister Varadkar and from my conversations with him on this issue, because, for instance, the Cool Mind Therapeutic Centre, which will be one of the leading centres, is situated in the heart of our respective constituency. And, in fact, both of us would have very strong connections because, for instance, that approaches a drug-free model of therapy. And again, I know, Deputy, you'd be very familiar with the different therapeutic approaches that there are. But just to say, this year there are extra detox beds there are actually more resources, and there are more earmarked health resources. It is still a severe problem for Irish society, I will concede that. And as I say, for any family who has to experience a family member becoming, as it were, for a period of time, almost lost to drugs. And we know as well that, for instance, the homelessness issues that we've spoken about before Christmas, that again, mental health issues as well as substance abuse issues can be very heavy contributors to that unfortunately happening to some people. And again, we devoted very significant additional resources as a government to addressing that.
Thank you.
I know, for instance, the night cafe here in the city has, I think, made a significant assistance in relation to that, and organisations like Merchants Quay have, you know, done enormous work in helping people on the pathway to recovery and to wellness, because at the end of the day, that's what you want for people.
Thank you.
Well, as I said, that's something that can be kept under review, but Minister Varadkar, as the senior health minister, is taking a personal dedicated interest in it. And I think that that's very significant and very important. I take a very detailed interest, and so in particular does the Minister of State.
Thank you.